effort.
Perfectionist.
So, it's about time you showed up.
I'd be much more excited if it had been a lady waiting for us.
I don't think I need to tell you why I'm here, you damned worms.
We're not giving you Relia.
Do I have to explain to you idiots again that it's pointless to resist?
The halfwit with the potty mouth is making another empty threat. I'm so scared.
You waste a Federation space! You'll pay for that remark! Force me! Wipe these filthy chimps out! Hey! What's going on up there, Vorsni? Vorsni!
Vorsni here. Three Federation ships have entered this sector. They have their shields enabled and are preparing to engage. We cannot offer any support at the moment.
Wait, what was that?
I have bad news, sir. We've detected transport signals emanating from the enemy starships.
Impossible!
Now the tables have turned.
You damned cheaters!
Who violated protocol first? Oh, that's right, you.
You unbearable little... Really, it belongs to us! Give her up!
Hold on to Rhea!
What are you doing, fake?
My life!
Isn't that exactly what a jingoist group like yours wants? Scream of
piss!
Grab it, well, that thing's our property, not yours!
She's not nonsense!
She knows why I'm laughing!
Stealing her memory!
Unfreaking believable!
Run, Relia! Miki, look out!
die, you pest! Whoa! She has other powers, too? That's freaking marvelous! Don't fight! Miki! Miki!
This injury's not just external. There's damage to her viscera too, I think.
Wait a second! That'd breach the U!
Boss, Miki's hurt. Avine's attack has her in critical condition. She's got tachycardia. There's more. Hypotension has set in as well. And of all of us here, she's the only one who can heal the harmed. There's no such equipment or cadre that'd allow her to come back.
You can't aid her at all? That's just... You're saying we wait until she dies?
What are you thinking?
I suggest that we all transport. In order to rescue Miki, the goal's equipment is integral.
Surely you understand the consequences of this.
Means breaking the UP3. Article 1 to start, I would assume.
Emerson to the Charles D. Goal. Do you read?
Yes, sir. What's the issue?
I need you to send the 9 of us to your location now.
At 9, sir? That many?
Wait a second! That'd breach the...
Unique situation. Do it.
Aye, aye, sir. Starting transport now.
Take her by stretcher to sickbay.
Miki.
To sickbay. Please come right away. Deck 12, sick bay. I'll take it from here. We're counting on you.
Will Miki be all right?
She's undergoing treatment now.
How's Miki?
Her vital signs have stabilized, so she'll be fine. She'll be back to her old self in a few days.
Thanks so much.
And to the bridge.
Miki's condition has now stabilized.
That is great news. Now you can invite everyone else up here.
Understood, Emerson.
You can call me Captain now. But Emerson's not half bad.
How could I make such a mistake? I'm terribly sorry.
I'll be up here.
I'll take you there. Bridge. Well then, so where should we start? We'll answer anything we are allowed to.
I'll go first. What is this place?
It's rather difficult to explain, but we often refer to it as a ship.
A ship? Who knew there were such advanced civilizations outside the Vestilian continent? You're not from Hadamal then, are you?
No, we're not. How do I put this? We come from a place that none of you've ever heard of.
I see. Discoveries truly do await us around every corner. Maybe he was right when he told me that fieldwork is of the utmost import. This is moving as we speak?
Indeed.
Your civilization is so much more advanced than ours in Santorol. I'm kind of shocked, but I have to say it's also an honor to be the only one at the Institute to experience this.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to our humble Charles D. Gold.
It can't be. Is this a map?
Smart, stylish, and intuitive. You are a triple threat. This was our location before we were transported here. And this is the Trekur region. We think this is where Little Miss Starlight came from.
Where I came from?
Of all the areas within the continent's arid region from which the snowy Aeheeds are visible, I'd say it's most probable that she's from this one.
There's no electromagnetic response from anywhere in it, though.
The facility could very well be cloaked.
I suppose. If that's true, then we've no choice but to investigate it ourselves.
And Miki?
You can trust that our medical technology will safely revive her.
All right, I will.
Delacroix, prepare to transfer.
Aye, aye.
Anne, take us to the transport room.
Yes, sir.
And we're off.
The transporter on deck 2.
You've gotten better at making the right decision, I see.
You call violating the UP3 the right decision?
Sometimes the rules are worth breaking.
I still don't fully comprehend why. But somehow, I knew that was the only choice I could make.
Your understanding of it needn't be complete. As long as you know what it means to hold people's lives in your hands.
Please follow me.
Hey, this is the room we started out in.
Everyone, please step onto this platform.
Begin transport.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Is this the place we saw on that map of yours earlier?
Certainly looks like Trey Kerr to me.
The coordinates match, so this is indeed the same place as on the map. But the real issue here is whether or not it has any relation to Relia.
Let's hope it does for our sake as well as hers. I don't want to inspect every grain of sand in this desert only to come up empty-handed.
So, what are we looking for?
It's difficult to explain, but please inform us if anything about this vicinity seems off to you.
Well, I guess we'll do what we can.
I'll help, too.
Thank you. meet in front of the turbo lift.
Technically on duty, sir, so I don't think you should be drinking.
We're already breaking a treaty. By comparison, this is a drop in the bucket.
You should still lay off the alcohol.
You need to lighten up. Besides, this planet's drinks are top-notch. You know what they say, where there's humanity, there's alcohol.
As you wish. Just don't forget your regularly scheduled transmission with Commander Dean in 10 minutes.
That's in 10 minutes? Why didn't you tell me earlier? Uh-oh.
Pardon me. Sorry. Pardon me. Pardon me.
Hardly worth the effort.
The more skillful I get, the more charming I become.
Explain seems off. For example, if you can touch something where it looks like there's nothing. So, think of it like an invisible wall? Exactly. I'm not sure I know what I'm looking for, but I'll do my best.
Thank you.
Elimination successful.
I'm okay.
Well, if you have seen it before, then we can probably find something about your mom and dad here.
Okay, I'll search really hard.
Pardon me. Whoops.
Could you elaborate on seems off?
Like if something were to impede your physical progress, even though nothing appears to be in your way.
Yeah, I still don't get it.
Our destination isn't that way.
Thank you.
The challenges lie ahead.
I'll do my best.
Thank you.
still have much further to go.
Sorry.
Okay then, let's reconvene in front of the inn.
Sorry! Pardon me.
This planet sure has a lot of beautiful women.
Do you always have to view things through such a warped lens?
Aren't you the one who says it's important to see things from different perspectives?
Don't twist my words like that.
It may take a while, but I know you'll come around someday, Anne. Hey, take a look at that pretty lady over there.
That's not seeing things from different perspectives. That's looking around like a kid in a candy store.
Sorry.
Adele, there are kids here.
I would hope so. You have to be a kid at some point before you can become an adult. No one's born an adult.
Were you a kid at one point too, Fidel?
Huh? Yeah, of course.
I wish I knew you as a kid. I bet we would have had lots and lots of fun together.
Pardon me.
Acquaintance of Fiore.
Yes, and I hear you're the most brilliant person to ever work at the Institute, Cassius.
That is because being a child affords me a different frame of reference. I am not encumbered with the same prejudices of perception that afflict adults, and thus I am more apt to make new discoveries.
Oh, so that's why.
Fidel, stop wandering off already!
I've gotta go.
Thank you.
I'd buy it.
I did it!
Pardon me. Pardon me.
Whoops.
Challenges lie ahead.
Made it.
Hardly worth the effort.
I'm really fast for my age. If you ever need someone fast, call my name. I'll zip and zoom over to save you, Fidel.
Sorry. Okay, then. Let's reconvene in front of the inn.
Kitty?
Sorry.
You're too young to be drinking, kiddo.
Do you like to drink?
Oh, yeah. I love it.
Even though it makes you make funny faces?
Yeah, adults love bitter things.
That's weird.
Compared to the bitterness of life, alcohol almost tastes sweet.
Sorry. Pardon me.
Thank you.
Sorry, that's not the way to go. Skillful I get, the more charming I become. That's not the right way.
Okay, then. Let's reconvene in front of the inn.
Captain Kent... Emerson, please keep it down.
Lighten up a bit. Ooh, check out that street vendor. Those are some cool wares he's selling.
You're going to make me mad.
You getting mad at me would be a benison. Look, another beautiful woman. I guess coming to this planet, this town, was totally worthwhile after all.
Ugh, I can't take any more of this.
Aurelia?
Everyone's together, huh?
Thank you.
yourself.
Thank you.
Battles.
More challenges lie ahead. Hardly worth the effort. I refuse to stop here.
Better than that. If I get married, I hope it's to someone who enjoys whipping up tasty meals.
Huh. So you like the domestic type. Who knew?
Can you cook, Fiore?
I've been known to make a dish or two, but I won't cook for anyone other than my future husband.